Now I present a very edifying case. What we see is the focal form of Hashimoto's thyroiditis. This patient was hypothyroid. But on the longitudinal scan, here we see this pattern. It is very difficult to interpret these granules other than microcalcifications. It is a very suspicious pattern. Here we can see a possible core of a possible tumor and scattered numbers of microcalcifications are found in quite a distance from this core. So this pattern raises the possibility of a multifocal papillary cancer. So this is a quite a rare finding in thyroiditis. Thyroiditis frequently has a connective tissue or proliferation of connective tissue, for example, here or here, but these granules are much brighter than this line, for example. The aspiration cytology resulted in Hashimoto's thyroiditis, but despite the benign cytology, I suggested surgery. And the final histopathology disclosed only Hashimoto's thyroiditis. So the patient not even had no thyroid cancer, but had no nodules. So this is a very deceptive pattern. And it is it is not the rule, this is the exception. So most of such thyroids with this pattern are papillary cancers. I had two or three among more than 20 such patterns which proved to be benign. So I think that despite the negative cytology, surgery should be considered if we face with this pattern. And one more consideration. The transverse section has much less relevance. Here, I think here is this suspicious area of the thyroid, but on transverse scan we cannot see this. Longitudinal scan is more appropriate to judge the thyroid because we see much larger part of the thyroid on longitudinal scan compared with transverse view. So this is a very edifying case. I do not think that we should draw the consequence that such a pattern is a benign pattern, but we can draw the consequence that such pattern can be found even within benign thyroids. So this was a deceptive pattern which proved to be Hashimoto's thyroiditis on histopathology.